Over the past few weeks, my inbox has been flooded with people sending me messages telling me about some app that stole my song for one of their video advertisements. Like hundreds of emails, Twitter DMs, Instagram DMs, even TikTok, which, believe it or not, I am on now. And all of these messages saying the exact same thing, that my Knife Game song is being used to promote some crappy mobile app called Swordmaker.
There is an old tradition, a game we often play. Start by getting liquored up and sharpening your blade. You take a shot of whiskey, you grab your knife and pray. Hey, spread apart your fingers and this is what you say.
I love knives, I really do. I have a passion for knives.
Now, I had never even heard of this app before, so they definitely did not contact me about licensing my song for advertisement use. It appears they just went for it and stole my content to promote their stupid little mobile app. And make no mistake, this app is freaking crap. It's a huge money-sucking ripoff, which I'll get into a little later in this video. But it's basically a, I don't know, knife-sharpening simulator? But who cares? That's not the point. The point is that they're stealing my good content to promote their bad app, and they're doing so on all the platforms. Real quick, I just want to talk about today's sponsor, Raycon Earbuds. Raycon Earbuds are incredible premium wireless earbuds with a discreet and stylish design and amazing high-quality sound comparable to other top audio brands that you know. I've been using my Raycons nonstop since I got them. They're perfect for listening to music, podcasts, or in my case, audiobooks, since I'm illiterate. Plus, Raycon Earbuds start at about half the price of other premium wireless earbuds on the market. And their everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. With 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a nice noise isolating fit. And it also comes in new, fun colors. So by going through my link in the description of this video, buyraycon.com/rustycage, you'll get 15% off your purchase. That's buyraycon.com/rustycage for 15% off. People have told me that they've seen the ads all over TikTok, on Snapchat, on Instagram, and even right here on YouTube. So the company that makes this app is called Plagendary Limited. Plagendary. More like plagiary. And what I found out is, it's not just my content that they stole. Apparently they've been stealing content from several other creators to use in their ads. Videos where creators are playing other games by this thief company are clipped down and being repurposed for advertisement without permission.
All right, what up YouTube? AbramSF here, bringing you the fact that there is now an ad on YouTube that is using my Polysphere video. This ad's actually put out by Plagendary. They like to, you know, just take people's content and use it for their ads, and they have a ton of money to spend on ads, but apparently no money to give to me.
Apparently, there's a mobile phone game company out there called Plagendary, based in Germany, is stealing Etika's likeness to use in advertisements. Here's a little snippet for you to see what I'm talking about.
Look at me now. Look at me, I'm the only I've made it so far.
Now, I could see someone making the case that these game commentary channels are using Plagendary's intellectual property in their videos, but it's still a weak argument when you consider that they're stealing their commentary videos and then using them in a mass ad campaign. And especially in my case, where they just straight up stole my song. So now what do I do? Sue them, you say. Copyright claim their ads and collect royalties. Well, sure, that would be easy enough, except for the fact that this company seems to be based out of Russia, and I am definitely not clicking that. We develop and publish mobile games. Our projects are original ideas, bright style, and catchy gameplay. Original and fucking deed. And there it is, Swordmaker. And they're selling this app on the iTunes store, on the Google store, all over the fucking place. So I went to contacts and I could only find 4 different emails. We got St. Petersburg, Russia, Yekaterinburg, Russia also, Minsk, which is in Belarus, known for their human rights violations, and Munich, Germany. And after doing more research, it turns out that their main headquarters are in Minsk, Belarus. Well, I contacted a lawyer who told me that this was pretty much an open and shut copyright case that would award around $150,000 per infraction. Per infraction. And they have like 3 or 4 different ads going on, so that's about $600,000. I'm gonna be rich. 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 Well, no. The problem is that while the courts would surely award in my favor, actually getting a company based in Belarus to pay me hundreds of thousands of dollars would be next to impossible. They just wouldn't respond. And from what I could find after doing some research, they appear to not have any American headquarters at all, or in any country that would play ball with American courts, meaning that there's really nothing even available for me to get out of a lawsuit. I mean, this is just the shitty truth. Foreign-based companies often get away with stealing content and face zero consequences. Just take TikTok, for example. TikTok, of course, is a Chinese government spyware app that's masquerading as Vine 2.0. And TikTok has tons of videos with stolen music, getting hundreds of millions of views, but the actual musicians rarely get paid out. I mean, hell, there's even thousands of TikToks using my songs.
Don't ever laugh as a hearse goes by, for you may be the next to die. Fidget spinner, spinning around. Fidget spinner, please don't slow.
Jesus Christ. But do I get royalties for these abominations the same way that I would if this song was streaming on Spotify or being played on a TV show? No. And while TikTok does offer an option to have copyrighted content removed, you can't claim any sort of streaming royalties or ad revenue. So whatever, my loss, I guess. And well, when it comes to these TikTok ads that are using the Knife Game song, I guess I could go through and individually DMCA each one to have them removed. But once one is taken down, it's like whack-a-mole. They're just gonna keep re-uploading more, and there's really nothing I can do about it. And it just seems like Plagendary is getting away with it, which leaves me with very few options. Without a working system to properly report the stolen content, I'm kind of just left with emailing Plagendary directly. Dear Plagendary, more like Gagendary, fuck you, pay me. Rusty. Well, hopefully I get a response back from them soon. Now, when I say that this app is a shitty money scam, I mean it. Just take a look at some of these reviews. 1 star, game's a money scam. 1 star, it's just bad even without the ads. Obvious cash grab. Stolen music. Good looking out. Honestly, just awful. The ads are unacceptable. Too many ads. Ooh, this game is terrible. Don't give it a chance. Copyright from Rusty Cage. Absolute garbage. Game's a money grab. Trash game. There's literally an ad every 5 seconds of playing the game. That's right, while playing the game, the ad pops up, and not just after finishing a level, but as you're playing the game. Literally every 5 seconds, you developers suck balls. Big, hairy, wrinkly, blue balls. I couldn't have said it better myself. Well, I guess the word is in. Swordmaker is an absolute shit game. Sure, it's free to download, but in-app purchases? Weekly premium of $7.99. Can you just imagine how many little kids download this free game using their parents' credit card, only for the parents to find out later that they've been paying $7.99 every single week to some Russian scam developers? And with 12,000 reviews on the Apple Store, that's got to equate to millions of downloads and respectively millions of dollars. Plagendary, I think I'm entitled to some of that money. But again, suing them would be the easy part. But actually getting a Belarus-based company to pay me would be next to impossible. So I wouldn't see a penny. I'd have to pay thousands of dollars in court fees and attorney fees, and Plagendary would just continue to be able to get away with stealing creators' content to sell games. And so really, what can I do but say, fuck you, Plagendary. Fuck you and your shitty mobile games. Fuck Swordmaker. Now, one thing that really surprised me about all of this was just how many of you took the time to reach out and try to get in contact with me to bring this injustice to my eyes. I mean, honestly, I didn't think any of you really cared about me. But now I know that you actually do. Now, I would never condone this, but it would be interesting if everyone who was annoyed by these ads would go through the links in the description below and leave reviews and ratings of their own just to let Plagendary know how they really feel about their shitty app. But again, I would never condone it. Just an interesting thought. Well, thank you all again for relentlessly letting me know about these thieves. And now I would like to take a moment to read some comments from my last video about another thief who I caught in my house trying to rob me. So I ran after the guy just as he was exiting the kitchen onto the back porch and asked him, what was he doing?
Why he gotta be black though? Why did you make it a black dude? Why'd you use a picture of a black guy? Why he gotta be black? Because he was black. Why the picture of a black guy? You made made them black! You didn't have to put a black person, you could have put a blank piece of paper! What are you fucking stupid? Why is the guy black? Racist much? Why is he black? Notice that the robber is black! Why he gotta be black though? Why he black? Why did you make him black?
He was black.
Why'd you make the intruder black?
Why do you only black people break in your house? Why can't it be a white person? The guy was black. That's why he was black in the video. What, do you think it's impossible for a black guy to rob a house? Anyways, thanks for watching. And until my next video, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and all the other social media. Goodbye. On a final note, Requiem of the Crazies Issue 2 comics should be arriving to my house any day now, meaning I'll be shipping out Indiegogo perks to all of my backers in the following week. If you missed the campaign and still want to buy a copy of Requiem of the Crazies Volume 2, you can do so by visiting my website, requiemofthecrazies.com. Oh hell yeah, it looks like someone edited Plagiandary's Wikipedia page saying how they stole my song. Plagiandary has been criticized for stealing a YouTuber's video about Polysphere and using it in an advertisement. Plagiandary has also stolen the Knife Game song by musician Rusty Cage for an advertisement for their game Swordmakers. Great work. Bitch better have my money.